Bring in Ajay Bodke as well. Ajay, your sense in terms of where with this big cut and the cut that we've had so far, can this go on in this trending fashion, or you think around here maybe there will be some support?
Good afternoon, Prashant. I think on 31st, I think I was on Anuj's show at around say 2:50 p.m. and I think the market was in the grip of a bullish fervor. And I listed out three global headwinds coupled with some of the India-specific headwinds. And I think, in my opinion, the things only have gotten worse from there. If you look at the global issues, I think, as Lata alluded, in addition to the heightened risk aversion due to the concern on global trade, we also have the November deadline looming on stoppage of imports from Iran and an expectation of a waiver, but which might not happen under the current administration. And the fact that the yield curve is the flattest yield curve after Lehman in America. So in addition to that, I think the fraying macros, I think the worry that the market now has is whether the RBI will be forced to come and raise rates more than 25 basis points, I think, in October. And whether we'll have whether there's necessity for a 50 basis point rate increase, not because the domestic inflationary outlook is not benign, but simply to give a strong signal to the markets on the currency front. And I think that, along with the fact that the crude also sort of, you know, continues to remain elevated, I think will necessitate policymakers into rolling out measures to somehow tamp down the aggregate demand in the economy. And in the first quarter numbers, we already saw that pressures on raw materials are clearly hitting the gross margins in case of many consumption-focused sectors. If you look at autos...
Yeah, no, I'm just coming, Ajay, to the sector-wise. I got your macro picture. Therefore, I mean, if you can just tell us what are the sectors to avoid now?
Yeah, so I think, you know, one sector where the market is very sanguine today is corporate banks. But I feel that the February 12th circular will necessitate further accelerated provisioning for the next couple of quarters. In addition to that, there will be hits on the mark-to-market. That's why whatever sharp surge in profits that one has seen in corporate banks, one needs to tread carefully, both in the PSU as well as the private-focused corporate banks. Also, I think, in my opinion, I'd said Reliance. Also, one needs to look at monetizing some of the sharp gains that one has seen on Reliance. And so is the case also with some of the pharma sector. IT not being the case, because IT is a clear beneficiary, whereas in pharma there are many franchises that also are import dependent. So I think, again, in pharma, case by case, we need to look at monetizing the profits.
Okay.
See, in general, this IL&FS problem in particular, first NBFCs, do you have any buys there now after the big fall in the Bajaj Twins and the likes?
I think we are constructive on L&T Finance, and the company fundamentally has been posting very good numbers. But I do tend to agree with Prakash that these times of heightened risk aversion, I think those franchises which are heavily dependent on wholesale borrowing are the ones that would sort of, you know, see their margins come under increased pressure. That's why I think one needs to sort of, you know, trade cautiously and just let this entire turmoil die down before taking any aggressive positions in NBFCs.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, I think I would agree with Prakash that the price has bounced back quite strongly from, you know, 450 levels. And the concern, you know, coming immediately on the back of the Halol inspection and the observations therein, I think does make should make investors slightly cautious. Also, I think we heard the Lupin management on your channel mentioning that I think although there is a deceleration in terms of the generic pricing cuts from America, but still I think high single digit cuts are still expected to continue in the current financial year and sort of, you know, also over the next, possibly also for the next FY20. So I think the fact that these stocks have had a very sharp bounce back should make investors slightly worried, and they should wait for the results in October to sort of, you know, take a further view on whether to increase the exposure to the sector from here on.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thanks for that. Last headline.